handout partway through here.
Okay. Good afternoon. It's 5 o'clock on February 14th. I'd like to call the Energy Awareness Commission meeting to order. First item on the agenda would be to review and approve our January minutes. Hopefully you've all had a chance to glance over them, and if you have any questions or comments, we should entertain them at this time. Jim?
Just a small comment on the next to last line in point five on the last page, where it says produce from your ultimate source. I would imagine that was supposed to be alternate source.
Oh, I see.
Any other comments or corrections? Not, I entertain a motion to approve the minutes.
I don't make that motion.
I'll second.
Motion's been made and seconded. Any further discussion? Not all in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed? Minutes been approved. Next item on the agenda, we'll look over our current CIP income and expense summary report. And William, any highlights that you'd like to point out at this time?
You know, I think actually for our conservation improvement expenses report this time around, I don't know that there's very many interesting items for the beginning of the year through January of 2017. I guess more comments towards the 2016 year that's not fully closed out yet. I hope to have most of those rebates in. I think I do have most of them in. And we may have a potential carryover for some low-income funds from the 2016 year to the 2017 year, just due to the potential completion date. And I don't have those numbers with me, unfortunately, so I can maybe put that into the minutes for the next reporting.
I just have a couple of questions. Yeah, you briefly touched about the low-income programs. You know, I believe previous years we've used all of that, if not more, of the 12.5. And this year we're only at, you know, about 60%, 70%. Do you think there's any reason for that, or?
You know, I guess I couldn't say exactly. I think their schedule may have been slightly behind for where they normally start during the year. I don't recall exactly why that was at this point. I think what did happen is we received rebate applications to hit probably about 80 to 90% of that funding this year. And perhaps due to availability of appliances, they were not able to complete those deliveries within the 2016 year. And that's likely why we'll be doing a budget carryover request for those funds to the 2017 year.
And if the commissioners would remember at our last meeting, we did change the recommendations on the appliances to make the appliances more available. So perhaps that'll work to our advantage as well. My other concern is the energy audits. Nothing has been spent there. Do we need to publicize that more? Because to me, the purpose of our commission is to make people aware of how they can conserve energy and use it better. Mm-hmm. And an audit would certainly be a key tool, in my opinion.
And I guess, you know, for my own comments there, that was typically used for equipment costs. However, I think depending on the scale of auditing work that's done, it can be used for labor costs as well to potentially hire energy auditing companies to do that work. You know, it either alongside with my own audits or just as part of its own individual program. And that's maybe something to discuss at a later meeting as a separate topic.
Well, when there's an audit, what transpires with that?
I guess a typical residential audit for what I would carry out at a home would be blower door testing, mm-hmm. At the very basic home level, and then infrared camera work, mm-hmm. to find some of the major issues. The blower door would depressurize the home,
right,
allowing you to, you know, find potential
areas. Where you're leaking out, yeah.
And also gives you an overall value for your home. You can calculate that by square footage, compare it to other homes to see, I guess, usually how leaky your home is, and if it's considered to be, you know, too leaky, if more insulation or air sealing is needed. I guess in some cases you may have readings that are too low where you may need an air exchanger. And then the blower door testing, or I guess, infrared camera, will show areas where potentially you have air leakage or low amounts of insulation. And that's typically what I do as part of...
How many of those were done last year?
You know, I guess I would have to check my records for total walkthroughs.
Just an estimate.
I'd say there's probably 5 to 8 that were done, on my side.
And this year?
What would it be? Just general walkthroughs for this year so far. So no blower door testing on that portion. I'd say it's probably around the 5 to 8 for just thermal camera work and
when you do that, what's the time consumption of all that?
Depending on the if it's a basic walkthrough, I'd say it's can be 1 hour. If it's a full energy audit with a write up, I'd say it can be up to about 4 hours of total time, probably an hour or so of walkthrough time. Potentially even more than that, than some prep time and writing time for the report.
But when they get that done, then they can see the benefits of some of the other things that are set before them of what they can use.
That's correct. Yeah. But it's certainly a long-term investment. A bit of time initially, and then if you implement some of those measures, certainly there would be energy savings potential. As far as some of the follow-up, I haven't necessarily seen a lot of follow-up done. I think people do appreciate the information.
Well, I think so, too. I'm sure they would. And, you know, when I read energy audit, you know, when I read the word audit, you know, to which I'm under now, I don't appreciate the word audit. What if we changed the word audit to something different? Instead of energy audit, you know, that. Yeah, I don't know. But 4 hours out of their time, that's quite a bit.
And I would say that's 4 hours out of my time. I'd say it probably an hour to an hour and a half out of the
out of their time. Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, we could change the name of that somehow.
Well, it'd be nice to have people use
people
it.
Away. Anytime it says audit, people, I don't want nobody in my house looking to see what I got.
Yeah.
And that's
I
they're going to be looking at.
Yeah, I agree. And it's something there to use. It'd be nice for people to use it.
It'd be a nice tool.
Yeah.
I don't know how we can promote it more, but I think we should.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up, Bill. That's really a good point.
But really, if William does more audits, it's really not going to affect the balance, though, because it's he's not, unless you supply them with some kind of programmable thermostat or light bulbs, you know, that you pulled funds out to purchase those things to, you know, supplies that you use for that audit. So it's not going to change the fund balance.
Well, then what is the $5,000 in there for?
It's basically probably was set there in case of audit equipment, newer audit equipment that you would use, like the thermal imaging camera,
is
updates
that,
to the blower
is that what that's
door.
For?
Yeah,
I would say it's a mixture of things. So potentially for equipment purchases, I guess for this year, I would say, you know, that wasn't expected because we do have some newer equipment. Shouldn't need to be updated for a number of years. But I guess it is possible that depending on the scheduling, or I guess, you know, depending on this year for weather, it may not be possible to get through all of the audits. And in those cases, we can hire an outside firm to complete auditing as well.
And that would be paid for by this.
Yep, that's correct.
And we've never, have you ever done that in the past?
We have done that in the past.
Hired outside?
On occasion. So. Okay. And I guess, it's also possible to look at that. If we were to expand the program to a larger amount of customers, I think that would probably be an ongoing spending category. I think there are many utilities that do hire those services out to other companies to perform audits. And then depending on the level of auditing that you're doing, it may be possible to exceed what I would typically do to a more fine-grained detail. And I guess if that was, wanted by a customer, it'd be possible to potentially fund that.
Okay, are there any other?
Another question.
Mm-hmm.
On some of these amounts where we're like $42,000, we're like $50,000 on a few of these programs here over budget. Have we got room to absorb that $50,000 according to the way this paper is?
I would say in general we have. I think we did actually have one year where we slightly exceeded what we expected to hit. But I would say, we've been slightly below the total amount of funding that's been set aside each year. I guess I would say, for example, the high efficiency lighting rebate program seems to do exceedingly well each year, and I repeatedly underestimate how many dollars will be spent there.
Yeah, how do we allow that to get to be $42,000 over a budget?
I guess I would say when the other spending categories are below their individual budgets, the high efficiency lighting rebate, for example, is a very good payback time for our customers and kind of a high kilowatt hour savings value for each dollar spent. So it's one of the programs that if we do have money available, generally like to spend towards those funds.
Well, yeah, but you didn't have money available if you're $42,000 over.
I think, but
that's okay.
If you look at the industrial rebates, though.
Yeah, there's other ones that aren't hardly being used, but
right.
I'm just looking at that.
And that's how, when you plan.
If we have a budget at our homes,
yeah.
If you've got $10,000 set, you're sure not going to be paying out $25,000 without it. Why do you have a budget then if you're not going to use it? But
I think you have to look at your overall total budget.
If you
look
at
for conservation
bottom,
improvement,
yeah.
And you're never going to be able to guess exactly what you're
right.
going to use. And actually, those two probably could be combined, your industrial and your, but you're keeping your lighting separate.
Okay.
Yep, that's correct.
Because some of those probably could fall under the industrial programs. As far as funds,
yep.
Because it's an industrial customer that's using those funds, but you
okay.
keep the lighting separate.
I believe our biggest concern is if we look at the bottom, the expense
mm-hmm.
total, we had a $274,000 budget, and so far this year we've processed $199,454.47 in activity. We still have a balance of $74,000. So,
okay. Just asking.
There are no other questions or concern. I'd entertain a motion to approve the Conservation Improvement Expense Account Summary for December.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Motion made and seconded. Any further discussion? All in favor of said motion, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. We will now move on to the Home Show Energy Survey, which was done in 2014. And I'll turn it over to William. And given that, perhaps we should keep in mind what questions we might want to ask if we propose a survey to do this year at the show.
Yep, thank
William.
You. And commissioners, I thought, as Bill had mentioned, with the potential to do an upcoming survey at our next home show, I thought we would review one of our previous surveys that we had given out for the 2014 year. And this was just a basic survey on green energy and, I guess, a community response towards green energy. I think a lot of those results were favorable and might kind of signal for the utility to consider green energy projects, whatever that might be, potentially with a community solar project or wind contract. And I think we'll get into that after we look at some of these survey results. So this first slide is just the general survey. We were able to get that onto about a half sheet of paper, or a half page sheet of paper. Gives you some of the question layouts. And just some notes for that survey when we ran it. I guess a couple of the questions did have multiple answers, but did not specify that you had to select one. So that caused some confusion for analyzing the results.
We should put that on the next time, huh? Select one.
Yet maybe necessary depending on what we want to review. And then probably the most important would be our question number four, which asked if respondents were willing to pay more for renewable energy. The category started from 0 to 20% increase and did not break out a 0% option. So we had the vast majority of respondents answer within the 0 to 20% category, but I feel that many of them actually meant 0%, which would have been interesting to have that as an answer specifically. We did have a few respondents who did not answer all of the questions. Due to the varied nature of the people who come through the home show, about 65% of those who answered the survey were customers of the New Ulm Public Utilities. And I would guess probably something around that will be the ratio for our next home show. So here, out of the total, 93% favored that utilities should provide a renewable energy option above the minimum state and federal requirements for utilities. So it appears that many people were favorable towards renewable energy sources.
William, you didn't break out residents and non-residents. You just put it all into one.
In that case, yep, that would be correct. So they would all be, just all of the customers were in one group here. And I believe actually here that's the same. So this would just be out of our overall group. This is a question about if people would like to participate in a renewable energy pricing program if offered by the utility. So we had 75% said that they would be interested in participating in a program, and it's not specified what that would be. And then we have how much additional amount would they be willing to pay above a standard rate if they were to obtain renewable energy. So 0 to 20%, about 76% of the respondents answered that. We did have a few that did answer within the 21 to 40% range. So we do at least have a significant amount that answered that they'd be willing to pay more than 0%. A few up into the 41 to 60% range. We asked what are some of the types of renewable energy that you would prefer if we were to offer those types of programs. And solar appeared to be the most popular there. with wind, you know, tailing behind. Then asked if renewable energy sources were to be offered, what would be the preference and how to obtain those sources. So a local utility-owned project, an energy contract with another utility, or a privately owned. And I would say that a contract with another utility would entail maybe a pricing program, I guess similar to what we had. We used to have a wind pricing program that was a similar contract where it was owned, the physical infrastructure was owned by another utility, power purchase agreement, and then a dollar amount was assigned to those. Privately owned would be essentially putting up your own solar panels on a residence or business. About 74% favored that it would be a locally owned utility project. And then the last question was, would you be willing to pay more for renewable energy that was produced locally than paying less for renewable energy that would be produced elsewhere? And I guess that would be in relation to the previous question. I guess depending on the scale of the project, it may be cheaper to obtain renewable energy sources through an energy contract with another utility just due to economies of scale. But it appeared that about 69% of the respondents would be willing to pay more to see the project done locally. And that completes kind of the summary of the previous survey that was done. I don't know if there's any questions about the survey, the previous survey.
Can we number the surveys this next time around so we know how many we're actually passing out? Because we have no idea how many went out.
Actually, I think we did have a total count. Let me see if I had that listed here. I actually still have a copy of those surveys, so I could count them up. I believe it was about 43 total is what the sample size of this survey. So it's not not huge, but you know, kind of a quick sampling of the home
right,
show.
Right, but if we handed them out at the home show, if we at least had numbers, we'd know how many we're handing out.
Oh, yep.
That's all I'm looking for.
And I'd say, you know, since it was at the home show, if they didn't want to fill out the survey, you know, then they could just put it back in the pile. They kind of fill it out there at
the home show.
So I would say there weren't a lot of kind of throwaway surveys. I guess I don't have a percent that was responded to.
So then if we put something on about solar garden, that would fall underneath the solar for number five, huh?
Yeah, I believe so. Oh, looks like my item numbering here is didn't get updated fully, but yeah, that would be correct. And I think what we may do here is going into the next topic, potentially talk about some of our future surveys.
This was my next direction. I was going to ask the commissioners, do you think we should put out a survey this year?
Yes.
Question, being the new kid on the block, have we ever put out questionnaires like this or surveys like this in like the monthly utility bills or some other format to get a larger sampling?
I guess for my history with the utility, we have not done that. I think potential future plans may include running with a survey for the home show and then potentially refining that survey into a larger survey. You know, I think there is interest in community solar, and once we've determined the best pricing and rate structure there, as to, I would think, either a newsletter stuffer, where it would be part of the newsletter that goes out, or as part of a billing stuffer would probably be be the most effective to get a large sample size and response rate. But Bob, in the past, that hasn't been completed before.
Is there a question like that on that city survey? Anything to do with anything like that?
I'm pretty sure not.
Okay.
In my opinion, I think we should start with perhaps a more brief survey to start with at the home show, and then develop it.
Yeah.
Based on what type of reaction we get there, we could promote it further.
Yeah, we have to pursue it.
For my personal opinion, I think question number one is fine. Question number two is fine. Question number three is fine. Question number four with the multiples, I would maybe try and reword that. Would you be willing to pay extra for renewable energy? Just a simple yes or no to that, rather than have them select an amount.
Yeah, I agree.
Question five, I would eliminate the biomass, just put wind or solar. Make it simpler for these people to fill out quickly. I guess I would delete number six completely and just leave number seven the way it is. That's my personal opinion.
I might argue with you on deleting number six, because it does have a significant impact on a lot of related programs, both with the local utilities and so forth, as to how they would prefer your alternate energy to come from source. In a home show, I can see where a lot of people were there might possibly be interested in private ownership of something, mm-hmm. On their own buildings or whatever. On the other hand, like was mentioned before, solar gardens and so forth are becoming much more popular. Several states and several areas in Minnesota as well have gone to contract companies coming in and literally providing their own solar generation within or very near city limits and so forth, then selling that to the city with people, buying shares of that and so forth. So there are a lot of different options included. If anything, I'd like to see six expanded a little bit to get a more definitive idea of specifically what type of solar source more people are looking at, rather than just, pardon the pun, but being in the dark as to what they want.
I would certainly agree to pursue that a little further down the line once we've established a level of interest.
That's true, yeah.
William, when we talk about what is the utility looking at for renewables right now, isn't it just mainly, aren't we kind of investigating a community solar? So I wonder if we should refine this survey to be more focused on community solar, because we probably aren't looking at doing wind. Are we, or biomass? Is that an option?
And I think that's maybe a good point to look at. I think based on some of these initial results and just general interest from the community that I've heard or other public utilities staff have heard, we do currently obtain actually a large portion of renewable energy through a wind contract with Heartland Consumers mm-hmm. Power District. And I think some of the feedback that I've heard is that it not being a very local project, not directly here in the city of New Ulm, it's harder for people to kind of physically visualize that is a part of our energy resource mix. And I think that steered us somewhat towards a local project. And I think the most feasible project there may be a community solar garden. And I think that is currently our favored project for any additional renewable energy would be a locally owned community solar garden.
So would we want to get more information on how many people would be actually interested in a community solar garden? And kind of gear that survey towards that. How many people are interested? How much would they be willing to pay for a panel? There's a lot of projects out there that we could kind of look at and gear some questions towards I don't know. That's just kind of my thought, narrowing it down already a little bit. Because if you're asking them about wind and biomass and that kind of stuff, we're not even looking at. I mean, are we even looking at that? Is that even a possibility?
You know, I guess I would say nothing's off the table at this point, but, you know, I would say if we, the community solar garden would be strongly favored at this point. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what we would want to ask questions for. At the time of the agenda preparation, I didn't have potential survey questions completed, but I did prepare just a document of some example questions that we may look at. I've printed out a handout for the commissioners for this evening, and I could potentially hand those out and see if they'd be generally approved by the commissioners.
That sounds very good. Mm-hmm. I guess I would be just interested in seeing if there is interest. And if there is enough interest, then we could pursue further, refine the questions a little further on a follow-up survey. Another thing I'm curious to know is if there will be any private entities at the home show representing solar power, because I have seen that other shows, there have been private entities there. Mm-hmm. And just to kind of gauge the level of interest right now.
And so, I think we should. So there's no sense, you know, pushing any harder than what we need to if we don't know if we have any interest in it.
If the people are not interested in it, then we don't need to be discussing it any further. So William had some questions that you were going to hand out.
Yeah, I think I'll head back and we can handle
another survey.
Over.
Bill, one thing, if you're going to have a survey, you need more room. Because when we have all them posters out there,
yeah,
there's no place for them to sign up, and then they stand on top of one another, and then they leave.
So that's why I think we need to have as simple a survey as possible. And as you said, let's have room for them to fill it out quickly and get it to us. That'll help on our
voting booth or something that you could get from the county, just set it there. So you could just step up to it, you know.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
There's some different variations, interesting takes on the other questions.
And I guess as you review some of these potential questions for the survey, I think that, you know, at this meeting, we don't need to have them finalized. So take a chance to review them. And I think we can try to finalize those at our upcoming meeting. And if there are any suggestions, I think open to ideas. So please contact me and let me know. Otherwise, certainly feel free to discuss them now. At this meeting.
Well, let's go through these question by question. Anyhow, number one, I have no problem with.
Yep.
Number two, similar. Number three is a good question.
Could we just, you know, kind of eliminate number two and just have are you interested in community solar, you know?
No, because then you're pushing for one item, not wind,
right,
or anything else.
We're looking at solar versus wind,
but really we're not, because if you get down here we're asking the solar questions.
Well, I didn't get down to those yet, but
what are your thoughts on question number four, which reads, should the New Ulm Public Utilities or other pursue community solar garden project?
Okay.
with a note, a community solar project is a solar array developed and built so that customers wanting solar generated electricity but don't have the space or opportunity for rooftop solar can participate by subscribing to the output of solar panels on a larger centrally located project and get credit on their electric bill. Customers do not own any of the panels or infrastructure. Any discussion on that?
Too long. They don't like that.
I agree.
Okay. And it may be possible to find a shorter way of summarizing what a community solar project is.
Perhaps we should just ask, should the Nuam PUC pursue a community solar garden project?
Yeah, just leave it
yes
at that.
Yes or no?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And if they have questioned what a solar garden project is, then we, as sure. commissioners, can elaborate further.
Yeah.
Are we agreed there?
Yeah, I think so.
All right. Question five. Would you purchase a share of a community solar project given the following information? 900 to 1100 upfront purchase price per 325 watt panel. Panel is estimated to produce 390 kilowatts per year, which would reduce your ability by 32 kilowatts per month. That's kind of confusing.
Per panel, it should say, at the end. I realize you're saying that in the middle too, but it should mm-hmm. be down there on mm-hmm. the end. Mm-hmm. And who's going to tell the homeowners? Somebody with the city's going to tell them how many panels that they need or what can get up to?
Yeah, I think you could. We'd be able to estimate that amount depending on
that. That would fall under the energy audit type deal, wouldn't it?
Well, actually, I suppose you could use that. We do summarize a kilowatt hour use, so or you can just obtain that at the New Ulm Public Utilities office anytime as well.
But the solar garden should only be used for New Ulm Public Utility customers. There was something. So somebody else.
If it's built by the Public Utilities
yeah.
Commission. If
yeah.
a private party would build it, we're opening up a whole new world. A fear that I have with this question is with a dollar amount right out there. If the dollar amount changes, the people will come back and say, well, on the survey, it only said X amount. If the dollars are different, guess who's going to get blamed?
Well, put approximately 900 to 1100 upfront purchase price per panel.
People will still they'll still stick to the they'll
yep.
stick to the number.
They're going to see that 900 and
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And Bill, I guess some of this this question was based on some other similar mm-hmm. surveys that have mm-hmm. gone out in other communities. Some of the wording that has been added, which I guess is not added here, is just depending on the size of the project, mm-hmm. Depending on the total size, total amount of customers that will participate, can change the pricing. And we could add that in to that question.
Yeah, I think in a way, question five is somewhat a good question, minus the dollar amounts on there. I'm wondering if yeah, it'd be kind of nice to have that information, but if that's something that, depending on what the survey shows, mm-hmm. should be pursued at a later date when you can get more, you know, maybe some better numbers with that.
So what I'm hearing is we could maybe change that question to would you purchase a share of a community solar project, period.
Right, make it more yeah. of a general interest question
yes,
rather than
more.
Numbers and
leave
details.
Out the rest.
Yeah.
Any comments on that, commissioners?
I think people are going to want to know what it's going to cost.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And we could answer that question for them.
Yeah.
When we're there, and we can help them fill out the survey.
And for how long can you purchase them? What length of time?
I don't know that we're that far along that we could do that. I think initially we're just trying.
If I'm going to make up a will and we have something like this, well, I want to donate money, and instead of donating the cash to a church, if I want to turn around and say, you know what, I'm going to buy these panels, or I'm going to lease these panels for another 30 years going to that church.
Mm-hmm.
That gets into a tax question, but
I don't believe we're that far yet.
Right, but people do that.
And that is a good question to ask, and depending on the route that we'd prefer to go here, either simplifying that question to simply, would you wish to participate in a community solar project? Or if we do go with some of these base numbers here, I would say a typical contract would be anywhere from 20 to 25 years is the expected lifetime, essentially expected lifetime of the project.
So how would we like to reword question five? Yes, we're interested to hear some input. Should we just ask, would you purchase a share of community solar project?
Purchase/lease.
Okay.
Could probably put, are you interested in purchasing a share? Because if you ask them, would you purchase, they probably think, well, that's a commitment. Are they going to have to commit to that if they?
That's why you put down lease, still.
Well, with
would
lease,
you be interested in purchasing or leasing a share of community solar project?
Yes.
How does that sound?
Mm-hmm. Better.
Okay. We want to.
Or you could just put, are you interested in participating in a community solar project?
Which would take us back essentially to question four.
What we have, yeah.
Could combine them possibly.
Well, you're probably not going to get that much interest if you're going to say, are you going to purchase it? Because I don't know how long I'm living in New Orleans. What do I do with it then? I would be better off leasing it.
And, I suppose this discussion does bring up some good points. It is possible to, do a very simple survey here at the home show and then potentially expand that once we determine some rough numbers here for...
If there even is enough interest.
Yep. So we'll, I think it would be possible to potentially just eliminate five, and I guess six is strongly based off of item five.
Yeah, I don't know that we need question six at all. How many shares would you expect to purchase if you're willing to participate? Because we're not near to that.
Yeah, I think six
that
would
process yet.
I agree.
Yeah.
And we'll move on to number seven. Might be an interesting question to pose again. We talked about it several years ago.
Well, I still think they need it.
I think we should leave that question in there, yeah.
Mm-hmm. There's people coming through town that ain't stopping because mm-hmm. they ain't got no place to charge up their car.
Should the New Orleans Public Utilities or other install an electrical vehicle charging station, either yes or no? I think that's a good question. Mm-hmm. I don't know if we need number eight. Would you personally make use of an electrical vehicle charging station in New Orleans?
Yeah, because if they know it's there, they're going to use it. You know, if they have a need for it, they would use it. Otherwise, they would just use their own.
And number nine, choosing a location, again, no sense in pursuing that until we gauge whether there is enough interest.
Yeah.
My opinion again. Any other comments on our 2017 home show survey? William, you'll have them ready for us at the review at the next meeting?
Yeah, I believe so.
Okay. All righty. And continuing on with the home show, our theme obviously is going to be solar, and this year, the interconnection document, I think, is important for people to realize that if they do put on a private solar panel, that there will be a document to make sure that they don't crash the rest of our system.
Yeah.
We'll have the fourth grade posters. We will be judging them at the next meeting.
Woohoo!
We've talked about the survey. Materials to be handed out. We'll have the rebate information there, interconnection document. We'll have our banner, some magnets, coloring books, and whatever Minnesota Valley Action Council can come up with for us.
What is the banner going to look like?
That is our next topic. You can see on our computer, there are two prototypes there. One that says New Ulm Public Utilities and one that says New Ulm Public Utilities Commission.
And yep, when staff reviewed this at the New Ulm Public Utilities, it was a bit of a toss up here, so I thought I would bring it to the Energy Awareness Commission, maybe get some feedback here as well. If there is a preference for either type. And I think that can be based off of your thoughts for the wording or just layout. Any feedback there is welcome.
Patrick, what's your personal interest? Do we want to include the commission or just on public utilities? Basically the question, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Make a choice and vote on it.
Well, the commission should be on there because it covers all of them. Covers everything, correct?
Yeah, I guess it would cover all of our various departments. I guess maybe some background with this is I'm planning to create a larger banner, probably about a 2-foot by 8-foot long banner to use at our various events, home show or career fairs in the future.
You're going to get that on a 2-foot by 1-foot?
It'd be 2 feet by 8 feet wide.
Okay.
I guess usually it's referred to as the New Ulm Public Utilities. Is that what it's on the letterhead, or what do they normally use when they do any kind of marketing? Or
I guess we haven't fully established. I would say if we do have it on a letterhead, it would typically be New Ulm Public Utilities Commission.
And like on the calendar and stuff, is it New Ulm Public Utilities Commission, or is it?
I can't even remember what we have. I think we have New Ulm Public Utilities Commission there, but
it says New Ulm Public Utilities Rebate and Conservation Calendar. This is basically to more prominently identify ourselves at the show.
It should be like that.
Because it's kind of been a problem in the past. People come up and, well, who are you with? Well, if we've got a banner there. Mm-hmm. I think that'll help us a lot.
It should be like that, the same as on the calendar. I didn't know how it was on the calendar.
But our commission here is not the Public Utilities Commission. What I was wondering if we could just add an S onto the commissions, have it read New Ulm Public Utilities Commissions.
That would be inclusive of us. And then just put the initials then just put the initials on there for energy awareness and maybe the long-term power, and just put those initials on there too.
Because we are only one subcommission of the PUC.
And how many other subcommissions are there?
Patrick, can you answer that question?
Yeah. If we're going to put the initials on everything, we're going to have a 5x12 foot banner here.
Yeah.
The only two that I'm aware of are this commission, committee, and the long-term power committee.
Okay.
Yeah. We should just put
thank you.
Commission. Just do the bottom. I like the bottom one.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Entertain a motion to suggest the New Ulm Public Utilities Commission as our banner.
I'll make that motion.
Motion's been made.
I'll second.
Seconded. Any further discussion? Not all in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed? There we go. We all got preliminary participation sheets. Check your calendars at home. Contact William. Let
know. Is there a magnet then to that? Is that a magnet that you're
Yep, that'd be
proposing
correct.
To make?
So attached here is a copy of a previous magnet that we had ran, and I guess I'm planning to just rerun some copies of those in the future here. Just gives a general listing of some of our various department phone numbers. I don't believe any of those numbers have actually changed. So just be rerunning that, but it's an example of the magnet handout for the home show and other events.
Very good. Do we have post-it notes left over?
We do still have some post-it notes that are left. actually, we are getting a bit lower on them, but I think we might make it through this home show with our remaining stock.
Is there an emergency number for the utilities, in case you have a problem with your utilities on the weekend? Is that number on here?
Yeah.
Does it say emergency?
Yeah, on the computer screen, it's a bit small here to read, but
it's an after-hours number.
Yep. After hours, yep.
Second from the bottom.
8204.
After hours, okay.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So, yeah, we do in fact have, you can contact us 24 right. hours, so.
Okay, so we'll go on with the magnets. Post-it notes, we should be ready for the home show. All we need now is for commissioners to sign up to work various times. This doesn't have to be done today, but whenever you can fill in, perhaps just let William know so he'll have the master calendar there. And it helps when our people are there. And it's fun. There's a lot of people. Any other topics concerning the home show? Be ready to judge posters at our next meeting. Are there any other comments or concerns with commissioners? If not, I'll announce our next meeting at March 14th. Being said, I'd entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'll second that.
Motion been made and seconded. All in favor, say aye.
All right.
We are adjourned. Thank you for showing up today. Nice.